All right, you incredible people, here we go. Are you ready to wing foil in 5 minutes? Let's do this. Let's start now. So, relax, you're gonna get it. What you need to do, you need to get the gear. I need a wing, I need a foil, I need a board, I need windy conditions, water, snow, land, skateboard. There's a lot you can do it with the wing, but let's just call it wing foiling on the water. So, what size board do I need? I want a board from anywhere from 100 liters to 140 liters, depending on my size or weight. I would say that's a safe bet. Size-wise, I'd say anywhere from 5 foot to 7 feet. Any longer, it just gets really sticky. That's my honest opinion. Foil, what size foil? Aluminum or carbon? Doesn't matter, get yourself a foil, but what matters is the size of the foil. Around the 2000 range is a really good thing. It has a lot of lift, very easy to learn on, what I would recommend. Wing, if you live in light wind conditions, anywhere from 10 to 20 knots, 25 knots, I'd say a 5 and a 6 is wonderful for you. It's a perfect size for lighter winds. If it's 30, 40 knots more, you're gonna be looking at 4s and 3s. Now, it all depends on everybody's size, but that's a good general consensus. You want safety gear, helmet, impact vest, booties, maybe even a full suit so you don't get all scratched up when you're learning. Now, contact your local shop or look in our YouTube. We have tons of videos covering this in depth so that you can do this and live it the best way you want to live it. Now, I got my gear, I go down to the beach, go to my yard, and I play with the wing. I want to get efficient with flying this wing without hitting the wingtips. I want to make sure I know what this backhand does. When I push this backhand, that wing comes up. It's very important to know what that backhand does because most everybody just pulls in, wingtips hit. We want to make sure we get efficient with flying this wing, and I want to walk one way so I know how to fly the wing this way, and I want to walk the wing this way because I need to go both directions when I'm doing this. So I need to learn how to fly the wing. So get comfortable with how to handle the wing, how to hold it, how to generate power. How do I generate power? What I'm actually going to do with the wing is I'm going to scoop. I'm actually going to go like this with my arms and I'm going to scoop that wind so that I can generate this pull to get myself up and generate pull to get myself moving in the direction I want to go. So I know how to fly the wing. I feel pretty comfortable. Assemble all my stuff. Let's head into the water. I'm going to take my gear, make sure I have my safety gear. I go into the water. I swim out. I can put the wing right under my foot and I can paddle out with it. Now, wind conditions. If the wind's straight onshore, hardest conditions. Straight offshore, make sure you have support. You're gonna probably end up going out or you have to surf and paddle yourself back to shore. Side shore is ideal because then I can go out, work my way downwind, walk my way back up. So side shore is ideal conditions. Onshore, hardest conditions. Offshore, make sure you have some support just in case. I go out into the water, I'm on the board. Make sure I know how to flip that wing. Play with it, learn how to flip it so I can get it into my hands. Now, I'm really good with flying that wing. I get on that board, I work on my knees, and I work at tacking 90 degrees to the wind. I'm 90 degrees to the wind, and I'm working with my wing to learn how to tack, generate power, stay on an angle, work from my knees, pumping along, scooping, scooping, learn how to stand up. All this, I'm just trying to control. Now, once that foil comes up, you lose a lot of drag, so it gets efficient. So get ready to depower a little bit once you're up and going. Now you're gonna crash, for sure. Get back up on your board. We're gonna go the other direction. Same thing, boom, we're gonna go from here, scooping, get up to my feet, scooping, riding, sheet out when I get up on the foil. I'm cruising in. Grab my gear, how do I carry it? Always keep that wing high, foil to the side so I can always ditch it so I don't hurt myself or hurt anybody else. I walk in, I high five my buddies and I'm like, I just learned how to wing foil in 5 minutes. There was a time of my life and now it's your turn. So I leave on this note, get one of your closest friends, ask him, say, let's learn how to wing foil. We're gonna do it. In this YouTube channel, we have absolutely every video covering this to the T to live your best life in 2021 and the future on. So I hope this helps you learn how to wing foil. Let's get you out there, live your best life. We love you, we appreciate you. See you on the water.